This is Prashant from Compilatory. I'm going to talk about CLI, Common MLI Dialect for C++ Fortran. This is Vinay and Ranjit, my co-presenters for the presentation.
CLI is a middle-level IR written as an MLI dialect. The level of abstraction is in between AST and LLVM IR. Currently, the focus has been on C++ Fortran, but it is not limited to C++ Fortran. CLI is target and ABI independent. We are using Clang AST to parse C++ input and convert to CLI, and while Fortran is parsed by the FC compiler written by us. We have a working framework, working LTO framework, and that we have been using for high-level optimizations. We have a working loop nest optimizer which has generic loop interchange, loop blocking and fusion working, and we have data layout optimizations working for us. For Spec CPU 2017, we have 2C benchmark passing, 2 Fortran passing and 1C++ benchmark passing now. What's the motivation for CLI? Flang is planning to use FIR, MLIR dialect for midland optimization. While C++ remain without midland optimizer, they do need one. There is a necessity to have a common IR to share analysis and transmission across C++ and Fortran, including things like cross-module inlining. LLVM is a low-level IR, which is good for global optimizations, but not cross-module optimizations. C++ constructed STL need high-level IR to analyze and optimize. For a long time, loop transforms, which involve multidimensional array accesses, have been tough to perform. LLVM has linearized IR, which is very tough to delinearize. For constructs like OpenMP, we need a framework to analyze and optimize. Let's take an example of a C++ STL library call, which we see in a benchmark called OmnitePP in Spec CPU 2017. This takes around 8% of the benchmark time. Currently, LLVM does not remove the dead loop. Another example of C++ quirk in LLVM, it's an empty string, assigned empty, and then compared for an empty string, but still it does not get removed. Ideally, main should have a return one. The multidimensional arrays, which we see regularly in Fortran, but as well as in C++, they are linearized access using GEP. Delinearization is a non-trivial effort. Currently, people use additional mechanisms like intrinsic and metadata to notify the multidimensional array access. Existing solution does not solve the problem, leads to poor dependence analysis, and which in turn leads to poor loop transformations. We have constructs in OpenMP and OpenIR, OpenACC, OpenCL, and we expect things like constant propagations to happen seamlessly. As we are moving things to a separate function, or that is outlining very early in the compilation process now, it's not performed effectively. Increased use of C++ and deep learning and reinforcement learning frameworks and libraries necessitates a high-level abstraction to perform optimizations.
Hi, this is Vinay from Compilatory. I will be talking about CLI IR. So CLI is implemented as a dialect in MLI IR. It has its own custom types and operations. So CLI doesn't use any of the standard types found in MLI IR tree. So the CLI types are target independent and they are in close correspondence with the C types. So the CLI pointer type in CLI represents the C pointers, and array type represents the constant sized arrays, multidimensional arrays with row major order. Struct type represents the C structures. The operations are similar to LLVM instructions, except there are few more operations used to represent different C++ constructs. So So there and also certain control flow operations like if condition. Sill ifop is used to represent an if condition, and we are experimenting with while op and do while op to help the analysis of IR. So the structure element access is a different operation. So it takes the pointer to a structure and a field index as operands. Similarly, there is an array index operation. So the unbounded accesses via the pointers in C is represented using the pointer index operation. So the array element types and pointer types are castable from one to another. So here is an example of SIL IR. So the module contains the global operations and the function operation. Except the gap and structure access, the other parts of the IR looks similar to the LLVM IR. So SIL contains both structured operations and regular CFG based representations for loops and other control flow constructs. So here is an example of a perfect doubly loop nest represented in SIL for loop operation. So as you know that there are various unstructured control flow constructs in C. So because of which the code generation part of the C contains CFG based implementation of loops and other control flow operations. So we do an analysis for the CFG structure, and if we find that it is a structured form, it gets converted into a nested region based operations like for loop, SIL for dot for or affine dot for. So we have represented C++ constructs using SIL. There are few more operations which are added to the SIL, but it can be an higher level operation and it can be moved out to a different dialect. Here is an example of representing a class in SIL. There is a class operation and the member variables are represented using a field declaration operation. Can also see that this is represented using the CXX underscore this operation, and there is a field access operation to access the member variable. There is also a member call operation to call the member functions. So the operations are in close correspondence with what we find in Clang AST. You can also note that the member function name is mangled. It is for the symbol resolution purpose, but there is also a original name retained in the function attribute. So the C++ IR is initially generated for the C++ code, and there are certain transformation analysis and optimization performed on the higher level IR, and then the IR gets converted to a lower level SIL form, and then eventually to LLVM IR. Here in this example, you can see that the class operation is getting converted into a struct part. So the member function is converted into an actual function with the contents of the structure as the first argument, similar to what we find in LLVM. So the CXX this gets converted into a struct element form. So similarly, the SIL part of the SIL gets converted into a LLVM for a given target. So for this target, the SIL dot it gets converted into an I32, and all the structure access gets converted into gap and all the other regular LLVM lowerings. So since most the Clang AST does all the template expansion, specialization and other things, so naturally all the templatized code gets converted into a SIL code as shown in this example. Similarly, the overloaded functions are map to SIL using an itanium mangling for the function name, and there will be an extra attributes to mark the overloaded operators. So we have also handled basic inheritance without the support of virtual functions. Here you can see that the class B operation inherits the class C operation as seen in the original code. So the C++ code part of it again gets converted into a C code, equivalent C code, and then the C codes get naturally converted to the LLVM IR. So based on the representation of C++, we could compile some STL headers like vector, string, IO stream, set, and we could write some few basic optimizations on top of them. So here is one transformation which converts multiple pushbacks into a single vector.insert, hoping that the vector.insert optimizes the storage. So here is the IR part of it, where the left side IR contains three pushback member function calls, which is converted into an insert function call on the right side. So here is another optimization where the multiple pushbacks in a loop are converted into a vector, are analyzed and represented, and there is a vector dot reserve call placed in the function above the loop, so that the space required for the number of elements is already reserved. So here is how the IR looks like. You can see that there is a new member function called for the reserve on the right hand side of it. So currently there is a decent progress in C++, including the basic features of C++ like inheritance, overloading, and templates. So most of the C part of C++ gets compiled. So we are able to compile some of the STL headers like IO stream, vector, string, set, etc. There are also 100 plus unit test cases, 80 plus CPP C++ unit tests which are passing, and there is one C++ 2000 CPU, specs to CPU 2017 benchmark which compiles and runs with a decent performance. In addition to this, we have two working C benchmarks. So now Ranjit will talk about how SIL fits into the Fortran compiler part.
Let us discuss about SIL, Fortran, and a Fortran frontend that is capable of emitting SIL, and see what are the kind of optimizations we can do on top of it. So FC is a Fortran frontend developed by compiler tree that is capable of emitting SIL from Fortran source. So basically FC has various levels of abstraction levels for representing the IR. So basically FCAST gets lowered to high level Fortran IR. So Fortran IR has operations to represent Fortran language constructs like functions, subroutines, modules, and the statements like print, write, etc. And this gets lowered to SIL. So SIL basically has all the other low level operations. So the advantage of this multiple levels of IRs is that we can do optimizations, different kind of optimizations at each abstraction level. So if we have any Fortran specific optimizations that can be done on Fortran specific constructs, can be done at Fortran IR level, and any other common optimizations can be done at low level SIL. So if we write any optimization at SIL for C or C++, that can also be reused for Fortran. So that's an advantage of FC over any other Fortran frontend, right? So FC has various levels of representation of IR and gives flexibility for the for writing optimizations at various levels. So FC is capable of compiling and producing SIL modules for two spec CPU benchmarks. And we also have an experimental LTO framework which can take multiple SIL modules as inputs and compile them into a single module and run some optimizations on top of it and produce a binary. So here's an example for Fortran IR. So basically we have Fortran program which just prints hello, and we have corresponding Fortran IR module. So as you can see, we have defined a function operation for representing functions or subroutines or programs. And we also have specific operations to represent the statements like print, return, etc. So this is very high level because you can see the print statement is represented using a dedicated operation. Basically, print needs a runtime support, but which ultimately gets lowered to a runtime function call. But before lowering into a runtime function call, we represent it using a operation. So we have more complex example here. We have a nested function inside subroutine. So the same is represented in a similar manner in a high level Fortran IR. So the advantage of this kind of representation over representing the functions as two different functions in standard dialect is that here we know the scope of func1 is only inside sub1. That is, func1 can only be used inside sub1, and we can do any kind of optimizations with that data in hand because this is more close to Fortran language. We can inline it. Inline this function or remove this function and replace the function call with just looking into the operations defined inside this particular subroutine sub1. We need not to look outside the scope of sub1. So that's the kind of advantage we have representing the IR at very high level or more close to Fortran language. So going on, we have Fortran program and corresponding SIL IR, right? So here, all the operations are lowered to SIL, and any operation or any statement for that requires a support from runtime libraries lowered to corresponding function call. For example, here print is lowered to runtime print function, and all the other operations like load, add, and constants are represented using corresponding SIL operations. So SIL LTO, so we started writing optimizations on top of SIL. At certain point, we thought like it would be nice to write some interprocedural optimization and link time optimizations. But there is no support for any tool that can take multiple MLIR modules and compile them into single module and do some optimizations on top of it. So we decided to develop a framework which can take multiple MLIR modules and compile them into single module and do some optimizations on top of it. So SIL LTO is the outcome of that effort. So we have a framework which can take multiple modules and compile them into a single module and also do some optimizations on top of module. And it is capable of resolving the function declarations with their definitions. And if there is any conflicting declaration of global variable, that's also resolved in our framework. So once we have this framework, we can write interprocedural optimizations like inliner, data layout optimizations. We can also do loop nest optimizations by inlining the functions. So here's an example. We have two modules. Two modules are fed into LTO framework and we get one module as output from the framework. Basically, first module has a call to add function, and there's only declaration of add function. Second module has the definition of add function. Now, with normal flow, we cannot optimize anything in add that requires any information related to arguments. Or suppose if you want to remove any dead field or do any interprocedural constant propagation, we cannot do it. So once a SIL LTO framework is in place, we can combine these two and bring in the definition of add and its callee in the same module, and we can do interprocedural optimizations like constant propagation and all, and we can also inline add into its callee. So this is the advantage of LTO framework. So we started, once LTO framework is up, we started writing data layout optimizations. So having written data layout optimizations in LLVM, we knew the challenges of writing it in LLVM. So in LLVM, you may be knowing, we have get element pointer instruction, which is used to represent array accesses as well as structural accesses. So if you want to find access for a structural element in LLVM IR, we need to look for a gap and see whether it is structural access or array access and distinguish between them. But with SIL, we have a dedicated operation to define structural access, that is access to an element of a structure. We just need to visit them and identify whether it's a dead field or read access or write access and all. With such operations, we could implement two optimizations, two data layout optimizations in SIL, that is dead field elimination and instance interleaving. With these two optimizations, we ran spec benchmarks and we saw up to 35% improvement in one of the spec benchmark. Overall, our frameworks looks like this. We have infrastructure wherein you can feed Fortran or C or C++ or even MLIR in SIL can be fed into our infrastructure, and that will be passed and represented using a SIL module by tools like FC or CML or CLLTO. Once we have an CL module, it's fed into a CL pass manager, which has optimizations like STL optimizations, loop nest optimizations, data layout optimizations, and inliner. And an optimized SIL module is later lowered to an LLVM module. So far, we have explored like decent part of C99 and C++ features like templates, operator overloading, STL and inheritance, classes, and all. From Fortran perspective, we have explored most of Fortran, and there are some Fortran features we need to explore. And from an open optimizations perspective, we have implemented loop nest optimizations, data layout optimizations, etc. But we are yet to explore other C++ features from C++ 11 and later standards. We need to see how we can integrate SIL into Clang and make use of static analyzer toolchain. And also we need to look into C++ exceptions. So as far as future roadmap is considered, we are working on loop nest optimizations and vectorizer. We are bringing in loop vectorizer into loop nest optimizations, and we have a common framework for all kind of loop optimizations, be it loop permute or vectorizer. There'll be a common framework. And also we are planning to integrate all these tools into Clang driver and
this is exciting work. Thank you, Prashant, Vinay, and Ranjit. We have a lot of questions, so let's start the Q&A. First question, how is memory dependence analysis done in CIL? Vinay?
Yeah, so we have ported the basic version of dependence analysis from LLVM for tests like SIV. So yeah, dependence analysis works.
Okay, thank you. And the next question, is there a plan to open source it, Prashant?
Yeah, soon we'll be open sourcing the CL infrastructure, the basic infrastructure will be open sourced. Loops will take some time because we need to add some functionality. LTO, maybe some more time will be taken, but certainly the basic infrastructure should be open source soon.
Yeah, that's good news. Thank you. Vinay, are you planning to handle C, C++, and Fortran arrays using the same CIL type?
Yeah. So basically, Fortran will have an higher dialect and that will be lower to a SIL dialect. So eventually, it will become a same type system.
Okay. Good to know. Next question. Which front-end is generating SIL today? Clang, something else? Prashant?
We are taking Clang AST and converting into SIL. And in case of Fortran, we are using FC, our own front-end for Fortran. And long run, probably we will make it work with Clang and whatever Fortran front end is suitable.
Okay. Next question to Ranjit. How do you see this interacting with FIR? Isn't it a bit of a re-implementation of existing functionality?
No idea. It's a fresh idea in FIR. We can always lower FIR. No, actually, not the exact FIR. We have a high level Fortran IR. So that gets lowered to SIL, but FIR will be like more of it than SIL.
Okay. Thank you. Do you have any data on compile time compared to Clang, for instance? Vinay?
So no, we don't have actually.
It's a comparable number actually. It's both are comparable.
Yeah.
Okay. Are there any loop optimizations implemented or planned to be implemented in CIL? If so, what are they? Prashant?
We have implemented loop interchange, loop fusion, loop blocking, and that's primarily whatever we have planned, but we are going to add one or two more of them.
Okay. Ranjit, I think we couldn't hear you. I'll just move on to the next question. Is it possible for transformations between container types, for instance, std vector or std array? Vinay?
We are starting with the STL types now. I think theoretically it is possible.
Okay, but you don't have it implemented yet.
Yeah, we don't have it implemented yet.
Okay. Next one. What do I gain from SIL compared to converting C, C++ to existing dialects like STD plus SEF? Vinay?
Yeah, one thing is it is ABI agnostic. And so the SIL type system is completely target independent and STD has hard-coded types. Yeah. And we have the flexibility to generate our own IR, which is more suitable for C and C++.
Okay. The next question is asking if there's any coordination with Flang developers. And it looks like there's an opportunity for collaboration there.
Flang uses FIR, a dialect of MLIR. And the only thing that we are thinking is we have a different design goal. Basically, we want to have ABI agnostic and we want to support multiple languages. So certainly there'll be some overlap. Probably once we open source, we should interact with the Flang team and see where we go from there.
Okay. Good news. Next question. How are namespaces represented? Do you retain the name of unmangled template classes? Vinay?
So currently we have everything mangled, which is Zitania mangling. So yeah. So even the namespaces are mangled for now.
Okay. Do you see SIL being useful for implementing compiler warnings, refactoring, static analysis, bug finding tools? Does SIL have links back to ASA like Swift's SIL?
Yeah, with So with the kind of flexibility with the MLIR and the high level operations we can produce, I think it is useful for using it in analysis.
Okay. Right. So the next question is quite similar to one that was previously asked, but I'll still read it out. Are STL types like STD vector or STD map represented with dedicated operations in the SIL dialect?
Currently, we don't have it. So it is represented as a class itself, but we do have a plan for that.
Okay. Has SIL been built with any feedback from the Clang or MLIR community? Is there any plan to upstream it to the Clang project? Prashant?
Feedback, probably no direct feedback because we did not ask. We were busy in building it. Probably once we open source, there'll be certainly feedback and we'll incorporate. And as we already answered, open sourcing will take some time, probably a quarter or so.
Okay. Right. Okay. Have you tried proprietary C++ compatibility suites like Plumhall?
No.
How do you make sure you're covering all of the C++ standards? Prashant?
No, we don't claim that it has all the features of C++. We use spec because spec is easier to test and get a favor or a result. We have our own unit test suite, probably around 500 plus test cases or even around approaching 1,000 test cases, right? So using Plumhall or any proprietary test suite is the next step.
Okay. It's a to do later.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there any integration with Clang frontend to emit SIL?
So currently the SIL is being emitted as a Clang plugin. We has a AST plugin and it emits Clang. It emits the SIL code.
Okay.
We haven't actually integrated it with the Clang project itself, but it is an AST plugin.
Okay. Good to know. Another question to you, Vinay. It seems there is no analog of mem2reg in MLIR. Do you build SSA when lowering Clang AST to SIL, or do you lower into something like LLVM alloca and then run a pass analogous to mem2reg?
We have a basic version of mem2reg, which is similar to LLVM. Yeah, we are experimenting with it now using SIL.
Okay. Can we use LTO module for other MLIR dialect? If the answer is no, what part depends on SIL?
Rajit.
Yeah, we can use SIL LTO for MLIR dialect. Probably handle some global, but this depends on that.
Okay. The next question is, well, I think it's a question for the organizers. Is the slide going to be available? Prashant, do you have any plan to put it on your website?
Now, probably the organizer will put it on their website. It's certainly available for anybody, and you can ask, send an email to me, I will share it with them.
Good, thanks. Is SIL intended to be a lower form of MLIR compared to FIR? Vinay?
Yes, actually. So it is. The IR is more closer to LLVM than FIR.
Okay. And looks like we have a last question that's asking if there's a mailing list or a bug tracker, you know, to follow on the progress of this work.
Nothing at this point. Once we open source, certainly we need to have something.
Okay. And that's it. I don't see any more questions coming up. So thanks everyone for joining this session and for submitting your questions. We encourage you to continue the conversation in the community board of HUA or in the roundtable sessions. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks.